Men of this world,
I suck. A tear who? IUICDC. A soldier.
Yeah.
Let them know, boy.
The awakening of Israel is a biblical statement. With fear and tremble on the face of the nations, we raising to new heights as tall as heaven. No options, we taking the kingdom by force. We endure for the heathen's enslavement. The awakening of Israel is a biblical statement. With fear and tremble on the face of the nations, we raising to new heights as tall as heaven. No options, we taking the kingdom by force. We endure for the heathen's enslavement.
See, I grew up with Judah. We was beefing with Ephraim. Then I got older, found Christ. It's ironic, we teach him. We the sheep of the chosen, but our heart is turned frozen. We in the last days, y'all stuck on purple haze. And I've been getting grazed for trying to spread this word. See me, I preach in the city, then head back to the burbs. Peep, my fringes, not just talking, we been walking, bro. There ain't no peace, but we still searching for peace. And you see us? Yeah, I know you do. You wanna be us? Cause we the chosen few. You ain't the 12 tribes, we know your father's all lies. We laugh about how you despise us, cause we still rise. I set my life.
Hey, Shalom Israel. Most High in Christ bless you all. I'm Bishop Nathaniel with Israel United in Christ. It's 2015. We're here at our men's conference, our annual men's conference. We have over 260 brothers where they come to learn history, prophecy, and intimate questions, personal questions, things of that nature. We go through a lot of things, including finance, marriage. We cover a lot of different topics. So, you brothers, you want to come down with this? All praises to the Most High. It's about nation time. Not about camp time, but rather nation time. A lot of times you see camp wars, brothers. My camp this, my camp. These camp names we all have are temporal. Because when Christ returns, it's about the nation of Israel. We got to start to get our mind set as a nation. The Elder Masha used to always say it's nation time. Nation time includes things that, with every nation, I'll say this, with every nation you have an infrastructure where you need things to build a city. Christ said, Israel is like a city on a hill, all right, which gives light to everyone. So our people, the men come in this truth, we got to learn to become men. Including myself, we got to learn, we got to build our minds. How to deal with brothers, how to deal with marriages, how to deal with work-related issues, how to become an entrepreneur, how to deal with our finances, things of that nature, okay? The organized nation, we have, like, people ask me oftentimes about the term, the name, Israel United in Christ. That's an organization name, which is temporal. I keep saying that word, it is temporal. Christ is coming for an organized nation. In the book of Psalms, he said, I will set Israel in order before your eyes. Meaning, and that's what's happening with Israel United in Christ. We've been set in order before the eyes of everyone, including those that hate us. Okay? So we have to organize ourselves in various branches of government, things of that nature, so that we can build, so that we can grow. The men's conference is very, very important. And the reason I say it's important is because America allows black and Latin men to grow up, but they don't allow us to mature. And when I say mature, I mean know those things that are pertinent to manhood. Know those things that are pertinent to being a good husband, being a good father, being a good brother, being a good businessman. Things like that the average black man and Latin man does not know. The men's conference comes in, we cover a lot of those things and help mature black and Latin brothers.
Men of Israel, let's rise to the battle, calling all soldiers, officers, captains, deacons, elders, warriors of the Most High God. The Lord has called us to the vineyard. Take back what is rightfully ours. Our nation, our heritage, the kingdom.
We be the warriors, the most high sent, so you know there is no destroying us. Ordained from the womb, prophets back from the tomb, to cast out all these false doctrines that is out to consume. Your chosen people, talking about we equal. Your pastor lying in that pulpit, they're deceitful. Not to mention that they ordained by the same man that took your land and labeled all of us some Negroes. So come get it right. Yeah, he gon' return like a thief in the night. So no plan, yeah, no plan. Scriptures cutting, demons slaying. Yeah, you Christians stuck in Neverland like they Peter Pan and I. We ain't pretending to. Unlike these heathens out here screaming, they identical. We the warriors, most our army glorious. We ain't stopping till we see our nation is victorious.
We warriors for the most time.
About 17 hours, all praise to the Most High. Him with the brothers, you know, just ready to take whatever come out, you know, the edification, the instructions, back home and apply it. The Lord's will, man, we'll get the Most High, get the increase, you know. Then I say shalom.
Shalom, Israel, Most High, Christ bless. 2015 Men's Conference, always in Tennessee and Houston, Texas. And we're going to get it in with the bread of, you see, hotel full of Israelite. Hey, shalom, got to make a run for the mission.
Hey, Shalom Israel, this is Boss Amaziah out of the Atlanta camp. We are here at the 2015 Men's Conference. Key word, Men's Conference. We're learning to be men, strong men of the Lord, all right? The, like the slogan that the Bishop, Bishop Nathaniel always says about this Men's Conference. We're going from boyhood to manhood to godhood. That's what it's all about. We're going from godhood, how to build up our nation, be strong men of the Lord, take care of our families. Better brothers, better fathers, better husbands, all of that. We're gonna learn that at this men's conference. With that, I say shalom.
Hey, shalom, Israel. Most High Christ bless. We're here at the Men's Conference 2015. A lot of brothers showing out, double the brothers from last year, about to get this knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. Shalom.
2015 Men's Conference. Obviously, around the Fort Lee. Brother Mikael, Vegas camp in the building. We out here.
You didn't make this. You didn't make this.
Slipping on your God. Step of game.
Shalom, I'm Sign Fresh Best. I'm Austin Rochester, San Antonio camp, Officer 50, with the Men's Conference 2015. If you didn't, if you weren't here, you missed out. This is the year the Nation United in Christ is going to go to the next level, teaching our men how to be sincere about the truth, teaching them how to be men and take care of their family, take care of their households, to be entrepreneurs. Because we've been in a mindset of captivity for so long. Now it's time to elevate our minds and our abilities and our resources together to collectively come together to bind, like it talks about. Come to gather yourself together, all you people are not desired, and come together and unify and take this truth to the level that the world has never seen before. We're in the greatest time upon the earth. The rebuilding of the nation of Israel, the true Israelites. We're the greatest moment. This will never, ever happen again. So again, Men's Conference 2015. I'm off to my side, San Antonio, Texas. I was the 50. Shalom.
Judah Beat Productions.
California, Sacramento, California. We here, you know, for the men's conference, getting it in, trying to find a way to build and grow more as a body here. You know what I'm saying? So stay tuned on what's going on, and we gonna be here bringing it out. And with that being said, shalom, Most High Christ bless.
Men's conference, man. We finna do it up. We finna do it big. We finna get a learning session on. We finna learn a whole lot about Israel and how to build a nation. The theme is Black Wall Street. We are building a Black Wall Street. We are building enterprises. We are building, we're gonna learn about discipline. We're gonna learn about family structure, how to organize. So this is the goal that we have. We're gonna learn these scriptures, go deep into these precepts. We got all the brothers coming out from all the states, you know what I'm saying, out of the country, in the country. Hey, we just looking to build and learn how to be a better nation. You know, we got one of the biggest jobs on the planet, and that's to rebuild a nation of people who are lost. Shalom, Most High Christ bless.
Christ West, Officer Ruben from the Bronx, New York Congregation. So I'm here to explain what's the vision and what's the movement of IUIC. Here in IUIC, our vision is one to establish a family. For the scripture says, well, you need a family member. It starts at the house with the husband, get the husband in order, get the wife in order, then the kids follow. So our vision is to bring Israel together under Christ. One vision, one goal, teach Israel repentance. And it's gonna be a great movement, a better movement than the Black Wall Street. As you can see, Esau is, you know, he's constantly attacking us. But his vision is always gonna move forward with the faith of the Most High through his son Jesus the Christ. That's how it's gonna be. Every day we're here to repent. We're right here right now to have a great time with the brothers in the main conference. And that's how it's gonna be.
Lagabuar out of Kansas camp. This is the 2015 Men's Conference with Israel United in Christ. Definitely happy to be here. Definitely happy to see the vision growing amongst Israel, see the nation building right before my eyes as we come back to our heritage, our laws, our statutes, and our commandments. To see this thing going where it's going is such a wonderful thing. The thing I could do is just to encourage brothers to continue to show discipline, continue to stay in order, stay in the commandments, stay reading, just stay listening, stay forever learning and humble.
Shalom, Israel, Most High in Christ, bless. This is the 2015 Men's Conference, Houston, Texas. I'm Officer Yaqib, representing the state of Ohio. Come down here, support the body. We got a Black Wall Street theme this year, where we're gonna be helping one another support our businesses amongst the nation of Israel. We're gonna be going into specific details on what we can do as an Israelite community to help raise revenue amongst our own to help benefit us as a society of people. So all praises to the Most High that I was able to make it down here. This is my first men's conference in 3 years. So I'm giving glory and honor to the Father and his Son, Jesus the Christ. And it's just an honor to be here. Shalom, Israel, Most High Christ, bless.
God is even a what?
A man of war.
What?
A man of war.
God is even a what?
A man of war.
First of all, I'm very happy that you've made it. Conferences are a very vital, important calling, especially when you're dealing with multiples of men. Because all of us have to come to the point where we are single-minded in our sojourn as we journey through this wickedness in our captivity. And we have to have our minds focused on the plans of the Lord. Okay? And the Lord has set us all up, not just us up here, but all of you, to be leaders. And you have to have your mind single and focused on the mission. And when I say mission, I'm not talking about missions with an S. I'm talking about one particular mission. That's collective unity. Okay, I'm going to go over briefly, because I know time is running. I'm going to talk about the importance of self-discipline and collective discipline. And when I say collective discipline comes into play when we all have our own self-discipline in check, and then we can work as brothers alongside each other to work for the one single common goal. That's where your strength comes in. First thing I want to do, before I get started, I want to, so we can set the tone. A like what Deacon Malachi did to wake brothers up. The problems that we face as a people, who's going to fix that? Is some other species going to come and fix it? Think about the problems that we go through as a people. Who's going to address the issues that afflict us if we men don't do it? Do y'all hear me?
Yes,
I cannot hear you. Who is going to fix it if we ourselves do not apply the laws of the Most High, His blueprint, His guidelines, and His Bible to fix it? How is it going to get done if we ourselves don't do it? I'm not looking for somebody to come behind me and do it. I'm looking to do this now. My reason for being on this earth is to take charge and take care of it now. That's where we're supposed to be at. Y'all understand?
Yes, sir.
That's what this is about. Now, in order to do that, we have to be single-minded in the program of the Lord. Give me the book of Corinthians, 1 Corinthians chapter 1.
1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 10. Now I beseech you, brethren, by the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that ye all speak the same thing.
The Bible says that the Apostle Paul said, I beseech you, brethren. That's what we are. We're the brethren of each other. And we have to see ourselves as brethren. Not as individuals, as brethren. In a single cause, in a single mission. Now I beseech you, brethren, by the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that you all speak the same thing. There's no S on that. That you all speak the same thing, meaning one mission. If you have one mission, that there's a particular discipline, the word doctrine itself means discipline. Let me, anybody want to say something real quick?
Okay, well, based on what you're saying, I was speaking with Deacon Malachi, and with brothers, with the Negro, with the Negro, thank you for upping my mic, I appreciate that. When a Negro or Latino cannot be corrected and he runs, he's not going to get the kingdom.
Right.
I'm going to say it one more time. If you are corrected and you run, you will not get the kingdom of heaven on earth. We always joke about the local hoe, right? The local hoe, y'all know the local hoe. She's a hoe in New York. She's busted. Everybody knows she's a hoe. She's nasty. She don't want to change. She's not going to change my life. She go down to Atlanta. She's still a hoe. She's not changed. Can somebody like that get the kingdom?
No.
Okay, that's common sense. Now we're talking about spiritual men. Spiritual men and spiritual women. Give me Hebrews 12. Hebrews 12. You brothers that run from correction, make sure I'm making myself perfectly clear. You will not inherit the kingdom.
That's right.
This is what some of you do. This is what some of you have done. Listen to what I'm about to say. Some of you get corrected and go, I'm leaving. I'm running to this other camp. Let's say I am a liar. You bust me, I'm a liar. Mm-hmm. Bishop, you a liar. Okay. I'm going to run to the next camp. I'll go to the next camp. I'm still a liar over there. They're just not wise enough to pick up on it.
Yes,
sir. I'm not getting the kingdom. I've not changed at all. Watch this. Hebrews 12 and 6, please.
Hebrews, the 12th chapter and the 6th verse. For whom the Lord loveth, he chasteneth and scourgeth every son whom he receiveth.
So now, whom the Lord loveth, he chasteneth. Right here, you with the white shirt, glasses, stand up. Give me some examples. Bring the mic up. How's the Lord chastening?
Southern Yehoshua, right now, West Camp. How the Lord chastens us is through our leaders, so through the ones who He's placed over us. Sometimes He'll give us correction through them.
I'm glad you said that, because most times when we think of the Lord's correction, we think of, oh, I got fired, the Lord's chastening me. All my life left me, the Lord chastening me. Those type of things you can't run from, you have to deal with it. But when it comes from the leadership or your fellow brother, that's when a Negro runs. Read that again. Thank you, brother.
Verse 6. For whom the Lord loveth, he chastens.
Start at verse 5 for me.
Hebrews chapter 12, verse 5.
And ye have forgotten the exhortation which speaketh unto you as unto children. My son, despise not thou the chastening of the Lord, nor faint when thou art rebuked of him.
Now notice it says, which speaketh unto you as unto children. I want to stop there. Thank you. Thank you. Unto children. Some of you come in. How long have you been in the truth? How long have you been in the truth? Three years old. That is a child in this truth. Let me see who else got a little time in here. Right there, you twice. How long have you been in the truth?
Less than 1 year.
That's a baby. In the corner back. Dreads, glasses, gray beard. Yes, yeah. Yes. How long have you been in the truth?
5 years.
5 years. Baby. Let me think. Let me look around. Right here. You.
Yeah. Been with IUIC.
How long have you been in the truth?
About 8 years.
8 years. Baby. You got brothers up here who've been in the truth for over 20 years. 20 years. So we want to hear a 3-year-old, an 8-year-old. We don't hear you. You have nothing to say.
Right.
You have gone through nothing. Read again.
Verse 5.
And ye have forgotten the exhortation which speaketh unto you as unto children. My son, despise not thou the chastening of the Lord, nor faint when thou art rebuked of him.
Don't faint. Don't run. Don't give up. That's what Paul is saying. Don't faint. Don't give up and run. Read.
For whom the Lord loveth, he chasteneth.
Whoever gets chastised in the truth, that's love. Because the scriptures of Leviticus 19, what does it say about loving your neighbor as you love yourself? What does it say about correction? Anybody know? You, right here with the greatest shepherd. What does it say? Tell me.
Officer Laga Boar, Officer 10, Kansas, in Leviticus 19:17, it says, if you love your neighbor, you rebuke him.
That's right. If you love your neighbor, you will rebuke him, meaning correct him. That's love. Your enemy, you leave alone. So you can't say nothing to him. Let him get hit by the truck.
Right.
Read.
For whom the Lord loveth, he chasteneth, and scourgeth every son whom he receiveth.
Read.
If he endure chastening, God deal with you as with sons. For what son is he whom the father chasteneth not?
If ye endure chastening, God dealeth with you as sons. Why? Because he's trying to teach us, trying to build us into better men, into better gods. That's what he's trying to do. He's trying to change that Negro into an Israelite. That's what the Most High is doing. That comes through time, experience, correction. Amen.
Verse 8. But if ye be without chastisement, whereof all are partakers, then are ye bastards and not sons.
Everybody in here is subject to correction. Bishop Kanai, all the deacons and captains, everybody, all of us are in here subject to correction. I say something out of the spirit, these men say, hey, Bishop, that's out of the spirit. Okay, you're right, brother. You got to be able to hear the correction and receive it. Who the hell are you? You can't have that mindset. Read.
Verse 9. Furthermore, we have had fathers of our flesh which corrected us, and we gave them reverence.
Right. All of us didn't have earthly fathers. Our earthly fathers at times, like maybe some of your mothers, were raised by your mama, beat you behind upon, based upon things, rules they set up in the house. And we still love them. To this day, we say, hey, mama, how you doing? Daddy, what's up, Dad? How you doing? We don't think, oh, I hate him because he beat me. No, we know mommy or daddy did that to us to correct us. Read.
Shall we not much rather be in subjection unto the Father of spirits and live?
God is the Father of spirits. He set up spirits over you to correct you. He is the Father of spirits. Read.
For they verily for a few days chasten us after their own pleasure.
Meaning your earthly parents, they chastise you after a few days after their own pleasure. Raheem, you didn't vacuum the floor. Pow, pow, pow. Now go sit in the corner somewhere. Cut the TV off and take your PlayStation from you. Your you're chastised for a few days. You get beat and put on punishment, right?
But he for our profit.
But he does it for our profit. Read.
That we might be partakers of his holiness.
God's plan is for us to inherit the kingdom. So he chastises us. He sends men over you to correct you and guide you when needed. Read.
Now no chastising for the present seemeth to be joy.
So when we get on you, you might be mad at that moment. That's okay. That's like when your earthly parents got on you. You was mad for a moment. That was okay too. But guess what? Many of you didn't run from your earthly father, earthly mother. But when we correct you, I'm out. You're going to correct me about not stealing the money. So it's only $7,000. I'm out. And I ain't coming back. You're going to correct me because, give me something else to keep this going on.
I abuse brothers.
I abuse brothers. You're going to correct me because I said in my camp that I'm over on another day for what you brothers are doing. You're going to correct me. I'm out. We see it all. It all happened this year. For the rock. You demoted me? I'm out. Watch this. Go ahead.
Now no chastening for the present. Seemeth to be choice, but grievous. Nevertheless, afterward, it yieldeth the peaceable fruit of righteousness unto them which are exercised thereby.
You got to be exercised thereby, meaning you got to go through it. You have to endure it. That's what the Lord is saying. Endure the chastening. That's going to make you a good leader.
Exactly.
Anything in the world, the devil tells you, to be a good leader, you must be a good follower. Right? Not a Negro. He don't want to be a follower. He went coming up. Our brother told us last week, Deacon Abiel. He broke out, gave us the finger, took his man, did videos, and said, I want to come back. But when I come back, I want to be over the brothers. I want to be an officer. Nigga, that ain't happening. It ain't happening. No, it don't work like that. We on?
Verse 12. Wherefore, lift up the hands which hang down.
So you mad? You upset? The Bible says, lift up your hands which hang down. Get over it. Read.
And the feeble knees.
And stop your knees from shaking. Stand up straight. Gird up your loins like a man. Read.
And make straight paths for your feet, lest that which is lame be turned out of the way.
Right. Because if your mind is lame, your body is lame, your lame spirited, you're going to be turned out of the path of God. Read.
But let it rather be healed.
I'll be healed through the chastity. Be healed. Read.
Follow peace with all men and holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord.
You got to follow peace with all men. We get on you. We don't hold it against you. Some brothers have lost their rank for a year. Some 2 years. But guess what? When it's over and done, it is done and over with. Let's move on, brother. Read.
Looking diligently, lest any man fail of the grace of God. Lest any root of bitterness.
That's what happens when some of you are chastised. A root of bitterness comes in your mind. How dare they? They don't know who I was in the world? No, we don't care who you were in the world.
That's right.
Read that again.
Verse 15. Looking diligently, lest any man fail of the grace of God. Lest any root of bitterness springing up.
Bishop, Aaron, Bishop, cannot correct me. They took my rank, they demoted me. Now in your mind, you start to get bitter in your spirit against us. The deacon said this to me, angry. You said my wife was out of order. A root of bitterness starts to grow in you. Your wife is a hoe, brother. Get rid of her. We see it all the time. A root of bitterness grows in you. Read.
Lest any root of bitterness spring up, trouble you, and thereby many be defiled.
You were defiled. Once you start feeling bitter because of the correction, you're defiled. You're angry because you're being corrected. You are defiled. Read.
Lest there be any fornicator or profane person as Esau.
Wait. What is he comparing the bitter brother to? Who is he comparing the bitter brother to? Esau. He's comparing the bitter brother to the devil white man. That's what he's... Read it again.
Verse 16. Lest there be any fornicator or profane person as Esau, who for one morsel of meat sold his birthright.
Esau gave up his birthright. I don't want it no more. So hearing this truth, I don't know. I'm leaving you. I'm leaving. I don't want the ring. I don't want nothing. You brothers got to do the whole thing. You're the devil. You are no better than the white man. You're not getting the kingdom. You run because of correction. You ain't getting the kingdom. You just gave up. Why? Now you look for another camp that's an idiot camp. I ain't gonna call no names. But you know you can, they don't teach the laws. You can slip by their crap, but God sees you. Or you want to start your own thing. I'm going to do my own thing. That way everybody got to listen to you. Nobody know what you're doing. Nobody know what you're stealing or lying or whoremongering. Like we've seen through the past month or so. Right. You're finished. You are the devil white man, and we're going to mock you. We're going to talk about you. So just expect that.
Right.
John chapter 8, verse 32.
John chapter 8, verse 32. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
The truth shall make you free. So what does it matter? Freedom matters. You enslaved a nation of people, destroyed our nationality, took away our mother tongue. And what does it matter? The truth always matters.
You a prince of the power, in the length of the hour, you see the strength of the power. First,
like
you
see
two and five, be a brick in this tower. Big
feet
that the power taking what is ours.
Look. Slave to society, built on the constitution that lies on equality, raising a land that was took into robbery. America philosophy trying to make me a mockery. I wanna be shackles on the minds of the people. We trying to unlock their brains while we fight off the evil. Rather than hear us from there, but we know that we need people. Well, it's time, just don't believe
it. I guess that won't be
no form of unity, destroying the unit with injustice and cruelty. The rich get fixed up by the poor man. Speech, we using that to get. Hoping the Lord blot all my sins. Give me the strength to endure to the end. Cause keeping your commandments the only way to win. The kingdom coming and I hope I get in.
Cause then I know that I'll be
on this quest for freedom. You enter into the straight gate and actually find the truth. Many will reject the truth and never be found. Some of us will fall and stand back on our feet. Some of us will fall into everlasting sleep and never get the chance to be. For once we were murderers, addicts, whoremongers, and abominable. But now the law of the Lord has released us from our bond and helped us become closer to being. For we all have our own trials and tribulations. But with fear and trembling, we have to work out our own salvation in order to become.
Sirach, chapter 34 and verse 10. He that hath no experience knoweth little, but he that hath traveled is full of prudence.
Now, I wanted this scripture because when we were setting up the men's conference, Deacon Yao Sop was doing the itinerary vision of mine as well. And there were certain names that came up to add to the men's conference, and one was Officer Zerubbabel, and one was Soldier McIntyre. And questions said, well, they don't have a particular position of rank. So I said, maybe they don't. However, they have something they can add to the body that we're lacking. I said, every man in here has knowledge, wisdom, some understanding. I said, we need people to add to things that we may not have the understanding on, what I can take, because they're coming from a place where some of us have not come from. I said, bishops are not the best of shape. We cannot do a class on working out an exercise. And that's hypocrisy. It's like I couldn't do a class on changing your name until I did. I said, somebody would have said, did you change your name? I would have said, no, hypocrisy. So I said, Soldier McGill has come from a place of experience where we have not come from. I said, there are things certain men in Israel can add to the body. So we don't think when we speak to you men, we don't listen to you. We listen intently. It might seem like I'm brushing you off, but I'm not. Yeah. Hang up the phone. But I'm so getting at what you said. I never dismiss it right away. I am paying what you said. Read on.
Verse 11. When I traveled, I saw many things, and I understand more than I can express.
How many of you men have your passports? Raise your hand. Okay, see that? So these are going to be your, like Deacon Lombard said, your international prophets. The rest of you will stay domestic. It's a big world out there. A big world. We got calls from South Africa, India, West Africa. West Africa one is the current one that we're dealing with now. And we're going there. Lord's will life last next year. But brothers, you must be a good standing, not a rabble rouser. We can't take this guy with us. Lava can't go. You gotta be in the spirit. Be a good character, okay? Show us that you can follow orders. And I believe Ithan's gonna touch upon loyalty. We need loyalty. Israel is a paramount thing. Very, very important. Okay, and a white man is really not worried about blacks and Latinos because they have no loyalty one to another. Whatever they start will fall apart because there's no loyalty, there's no love amongst them. When I say I'm talking about that brotherly love, it's not there. They will betray one another, backstab one another, tailbear against one another. That's a Negro's attribute. Okay, so white man's not really worried about this too much. But in this thing that we're trying to do in the name of the Lord is weed out those Judas Iscariot spirits that we don't have the potential to have. We have to get it out of us, all of us.
Okay, you sow sparingly, you shall reap sparingly. Don't play with the word of the Most High. Verse 11. Same chapter. Bishop, bring it out.
Read that. First Corinthians
chapter 12, verse 11. But all these things worketh that one and self in the self same spirit, dividing to every man separately as he will.
So some of you brothers have several talents. Okay, like for example, I'm an artist, but that's not my main thing. I can support brothers who are in the art field, but my main thing is teaching, guiding in a leadership position. That's where I'm at right now, prophesying as well. Everybody has several gifts. Many of you have several gifts. We've come to a point where we've realized that some of you are not like Joseph of Arimathea, okay? Is he going to get the kingdom? Y'all think? Mm-hmm. Hello?
Yes.
Okay. What was his role? What about you, Solomon? What was his role?
Solomon, New York, officer of the team. We had a burial ground.
So what about it? So I got one too, Emmy.
He provided it for the nation.
You provided for the nation.
So people that couldn't bury people or they had to pay for it, he took care of stuff like that.
Somebody. Maybe Gabriel.
Officer Gabriel, Chicago. He financially helped the troops.
Okay.
And his position in the Sanhedrin.
And?
Nobody say it.
That's all I got.
Thank you, Gabriel.
Solomon was okay, you okay, but he's always, come on, you.
All right, Soldier Mapuara from Dallas, Texas. He took the body of Christ.
I think I don't want to hear that. He's the one that was friends with Pilate, used his influence to go in there and get the body of him and Nicodemus.
That's a help.
Right. He's going to get the kingdom, but he was not in the position that the apostles were. You understand that?
Yes, sir.
He had a different role to play. You have women, for example, just for example, in Luke, was it Luke 8? That's what they provided Christ with their substance. They're going to get the kingdom too. You had to do it on the cross. Christ, at this day, you should be with me in the kingdom. We've come to the point where we know some of you are not soldiers. I'm going to explain what I mean by that. Some of you do excellent work for Israel, but when it comes to being a soldier, you know what it means to be a soldier? You're going to boots on the ground when we need you. Go out to camp. War. Some of you are not built like that.
I'm sorry, you can take some men that are warriors, and then you try to put them in administration role,
right,
and he'll jack this whole thing up.
Right.
Yeah, you're in administration role. You're like, he's over the money, and you come back, and all he bought was swords. You see the paper, right? You understand? Everybody, so what the bishop said, I'm going to go is that the Most High is showing us that we're coming out of that phase of it's necessary to have every man come through the same pipeline. We don't need that no more. We want men to have willing spirits that want to go to camp. And or we want men with willing spirits to play their perspective role in whatever it might be. But out in camp, you need men that are sincere, that desire this position. Because what you're doing when you're teaching, you're expecting that the man next to you, on either side and behind you, is really about this. I want to go home to my wife. If the Most High spares my life with his bullet, and I need to know the man standing behind me is really watching my back, and he don't go like this.
Right.
And I catch it in my head. I need him to say, Doc!
Right.
I need to, you know, so I'd rather know I don't have it. No, it's just me and you. We both put our back to the wall, and we just have at it. I don't know what to expect.
Christ bless. We at the men's conference 2015.
to see the growth in the body of the Spirit of the Most High in Christ, right? We're moving past. Let's go out and continue to try to teach, just only teaching. We're developing and bringing the things that are needful to the body. We're taking the next steps in building the nation, all right? It starts with things like these conferences. Every year, more and more information come out so brothers can fully change and renew their mind. All praise to the Most High Christ.
All praise.
Thank you.
time to get a fellowship. Hopefully we can spread this message on, people know that it's time to repent, build back the nation of Israel. One mind, one spirit under Christ.
Yeah. 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 Ye
existence everlasting. Ain't hard to imagine. Kingdom God coming with force taken, not asking. This world is passing. The ways of advancement taught the word of God is spirit and truth. No, you haven't. Take notes like a class session. Mass deception has conquered our people. But we preach the sequel when the chosen race we speak to. Rise up and reason to them people beat you. Made you up the demon that they teach you. You're more than a freak, much more than a street dude. Open that book and read through it. Tell me if you see you. With hatred they deceive you. Magic they can be. Get first the prophecy and that devil will come see through. Ever been told that inherit the earth is what they mean to? Ever been shown love and kindness and peace to? My Lord's coming back. Jesus Christ, so get ready. Keep the commandments to live. If not, own up and damn it. King the king, God the truth, awaiting the blessing.
Boyhood to manhood to godhood.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to Join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.